بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Welcome brothers and sisters to our daily Ramadan reflections. Today we are on our fourth night of Ramadan, walhamdulillah. And as usual, as part of our daily reflection, inshallah, we're going to be looking again every day, inshallah, bidnillah, at a verse or multiple verses from each juz. And today we are on the fifth juz. I also want to mention that previously we were speaking about a prophet as well and mentioning one of the prophets in each night. But subhanAllah, we felt that the videos were becoming a bit lengthy. So inshallah, we are going to simply stick to the verses, inshallah, because of the fact that this is the month of Ramadan. This is the month of the Holy Quran. So the Quran takes precedence. So inshallah, we will stick to the verse or verses from each juz, bi'ithnillah. Again, today we'll be looking at the fifth juz. And today we'll be looking at Surah An-Nisa. We are in Surah An-Nisa, verse 135, inshallah. Wallahi, a very, very powerful verse, packed with many, many insights, subhanAllah. And it revolves around justice. Again, this is verse 135 from Surah An-Nisa, where Allah Azza wa Jal tells us, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا كونوا قوامين بالقسط شهداء لله كونوا قوامين بالقسط شهداء لله ولو على أنفسكم أو الوالدين والأقربين إن يكن غنيا أو فقيرا فالله أولى بهما فلا تتبعوا الهوى أن تعدلوا وإن تلووا أو تعرضوا فإن الله كان بما تعملون خبيرا. سبحان الله. Allah Azza wa Jal tells us in this beautiful verse, O you who have believed, be persistently standing firm in justice, witnesses for Allah, even if it be against yourselves or parents and relatives. Whether one is rich or poor, Allah is more worthy of both. So follow not personal inclinations, lest you not be just. And if you distort your testimony or refuse to give it, then indeed Allah is ever with what you do acquainted. SubhanAllah, SubhanAllah. Brothers and sisters, wallahi, this is one of the verses, one of the many verses, wallahi, that makes an individual fall in love with this beautiful religion all over again. Truly. This verse reminds us that Islam is for justice. Islam is for justice. It doesn't matter if it's against yourself or your parents or your relatives or the rich or poor. It is here لِلْعَدْلِ. SubhanAllah. So again, Allah Azza wa Jal tells us that we must stand firm, persistently stand firm in justice, even if it be against yourselves. SubhanAllah. Brothers and sisters, let me ask you this. Who are you most inclined to be biased towards? And it doesn't have to be, you know, a large, very serious situation. It could be something very minuscule. No matter what the case is, who are you most inclined to be biased towards? Yourself, صح ولا لا. And then who? Then your parents. And then who? Your loved ones, your relatives. So again, Allah is giving us the extremes here. Allah is telling us that we must stand firm in justice, even if it is against ourselves or our parents or our loved ones. SubhanAllah. No excuses. You know, it's very interesting, especially the parents aspect, you know, because many people think, you know, what about the rights of parents? Again, the parents are a very, very, very big part of our religion. SubhanAllah. However, when it comes to al-adl, when it comes to being just, there's no swaying. There's no excuses for this. And then Allah Azza wa Jal tells us, even whether one is rich or poor. So, for example, if an individual is rich or comes from مثلاً, a rich family, you know, one may say, you know, this is you know, the son of so and so, or the daughter of so and so. So, you know, maybe we want to approach this in a different way. Maybe we can, you know, maybe cut them some slack, this, that, and the next. Again, Allah is telling you, whether one is rich or poor. Again, on the other end of this, one may be poor. And one may make excuses for this individual and state that, you know, subhanAllah, this person had a rough upbringing, this, that, and the next. But again, Allah is saying, when it comes to al-adl, Allah is more worthy of both. And then towards the end, and I think this is one of my favorite points of this verse, subhanAllah. And that is that Allah Azza wa Jalla tells us, and if you distort your testimony or refuse to give it, so then indeed Allah is ever with what you do acquainted. So again, what an individual may go as far as to distort their testimony. Again, if they are brought forward as a witness, they may, again, if they're inclined one way or another, if they are biased, they may state certain things that makes this individual look wrong when they are in the right. And they may end up having this individual end up in a situation where it is an unjust situation and they shouldn't have been in the first place. Again, this is one thing. However, Allah also mentions, or if you refuse to give it. This is very interesting, subhanAllah. So again, so an individual may not want to, again, in the first situation, this individual clearly is going out of their way to bring harm upon this person. But to refuse to give the testimony, maybe this person just doesn't want to deal with it. Maybe this person just is like, yeah, I have enough on my plate as it is. I don't want to deal with anything else. Just leave me out of this situation. Nafsi, please leave me alone. I don't want to deal with it. However, brothers and sisters, if this person, if he or she has the ability to prove this individual's innocence, yet they stay out of the situation, yet they refuse to give testimony, they will be held accountable. And that is why, again, Allah tells us, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرًا. SubhanAllah. I ask Allah to give us the ability and make us stand firm in justice persistently, inshallah, even if it is against ourselves. And as always, I ask Allah to give us the ability to take full advantage of this beautiful and blessed month, bi-idhnillah. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت استغفرك وأتوب إليك وجزاكم الله خيرا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.